My name is Nicklas Brendborg. I'm 28 years old and I'm a PhD student and a science writer. My newest book is called The Blue Egg, and this book is about how we are manipulated by various industries that take advantage of the fact that we have brains evolved in the Stone Age but are now faced with modern technology. So that means you can get us to eat way too much food, you can get us to become totally addicted to sitting behind screens. We get addicted to drugs, and there's all these different kinds of what is called super stimuli that we are really, really bad at avoiding. The reason the blue egg is really important right now is because we are falling further and further into the depths of this manipulation that is done to us by industry. So the obesity rates have never been higher around the world and are still growing, not just in the developed world, but in definitely also in the developing world. So some of the most overweight countries are now countries like Egypt and Mexico and various other Latin American and Middle Eastern countries that are not exactly rich. And even if we go to Africa, that used to have big problems with the underweight kids, for instance, now you actually have more African people dying from overweight related conditions than from underweight and starvation and that sort. We're also spending more and more time on our phones because we are getting manipulated into that. We are spending less time in general out and about in the real world. So we can actually see that this affects people in various ways. We have high rates of mental illness, especially among young people. We have more people reporting themselves as lonely than ever before. We have fewer marriages, we have fewer kids, fewer people that even report they have a significant other of any kind. So as we are getting sucked into the digital world by these super stimuli, we are starting to leave the real world behind, and that has some drastic consequences for how we thrive in the world. The blue egg in the title of the book refers to this experiment, or these experiments that were done by a Dutch scientist called Nicolas Tinbergen back in the 1950s. He's the person that coined something called a super stimuli, and basically his observation was that he did some studies on birds where he made fake eggs for these birds that were a lot larger than the eggs that these birds naturally lay, and that was also way more colorful. Then when Tinbergen took these eggs and put them into the cages of his birds, he could see that they much preferred these exaggerated versions of the natural eggs, so the ones that are bigger and brighter and just in general more colorful. A super stimuli is an exaggeration of something that we're normally attracted to. For instance, candy could be one example where humans like something like food that tastes a little sweet, but today we can make food that is tons, or that is several times sweeter than you could ever find in our natural environment. So we can isolate sugar and just add it in droves to our food, and that makes it and that puts the human reward system into overdrive. You can do sort of the same thing when you make digital products. So you can say, what is something about, say, being social that we humans really like, and then you can isolate it and give us in huge amounts. For instance, the like function on social media is just that. It's a form of social approval where instead of having one or two people maybe in a day say something nice to you, you can get the approval of 50 or 100 or maybe even thousands of people in a very, very short time span. So that works, that hits the reward system the same way that something really, really sugary hits it, where we're not really built to expect these kinds of huge rewards, and that makes them really hard to resist for us, leading to this addiction-like behavior that a lot of us have with junk food and with our phones and with computer screens and so on. Everyone should read this book because I don't think there is a person in the modern world that don't have one of these problems that I'm describing. It could be problems with everything from pornography to video games to binging Netflix series, all these various things that have become kind of our modern addictions that are really, really hard to break. So in the book, you'll get knowledge about why this is, how it works, and also, of course, all the good advice that I have on how to break down these forms of manipulation.